everyone. You're watching News Epicenter with me, Maria Shakil. Reforms in the education sector is the need of the hour, as every year millions of students see daunting cutoffs which prevent many 90 percenters from entering top central universities. Now, in a big move, the center has announced a common aptitude test from 2021. The government has set up a 7-member committee to work out the modalities for this test. There will be a general test as well as subject-specific test, which will be conducted once a year. The move is expected to ease the academic pressure on students by bringing a uniform platform for admissions. UGC chairperson, in fact, Professor D.P. Singh, said the committee is expected to submit its recommendations in a month's time. The computer-based common entrance test will be conducted by the National Testing Agency, that is the NTA, and will be mandatory for admissions to all 54 central universities. Officials at the Ministry of Education have said that it would give an opportunity to universities to enroll aspirants with aptitude, because this is being called as an aptitude test for a course, and also eliminate the need to appear in multiple admissions and entrance exams. The minimum eligibility to be set for the test would also ensure that more candidates are eligible for admission. For example, at present, any unreserved candidate with even 90% in the best of 4 in class 12 board exams cannot secure a seat in the commerce stream in most of University of Delhi colleges. But even a candidate with 60% will be able to sit for the common entrance exam and possibly qualify for admissions. Moreover, difference in evaluation scheme of various boards have been a concern for UG admissions, that is the undergraduate admissions. Typically, higher scoring science stream students edge out aspirants in social science subjects on the basis of class 12 board exams. So, will this new system introduce a level playing field for millions of students across the country and ensure good higher education for one and all? Joining me now, Dr. Geeta Bhatt, she's an academician. Also on the show, Professor Chandrachur Singh, he's a senior professor at the Hindu College of Delhi University. Sumit Raghav is a class 12 student. Bhanu Pratap is a class 12 student. I'm going to begin with the students first, and Sumit, come in on this. Is this move in your interest? Is there some problem with the audio there? Sumit, have you muted your phone, because we cannot hear you?
Now you are able to?
Yes, please go ahead.
Okay. I am in the favor of this decision. The decision is very good for the student. First thing is that in this decision, the opportunity for the student who scored less marks in board exam, they have more opportunities. So if the opportunities for the all the student is more, so this is a good decision by the government.
नहीं, लेकिन सुमित, सवाल तो ये उठता है ना, जो जिनके अच्छे नंबर आएंगे वो क्यों आपके साथ बैठे हैं जिनके कम नंबर है?
बट मैम, अगर आप इसका ये भी देखें कि जिनके कम नंबर आए हैं, मान लीजिए आप 90 प्लस वालों के तो आप कॉलेज मिल जाएंगी, पर जिनके 89, 88 तो उनको भी अपॉर्चुनिटीज मिलेंगी. तो इस पे हम ये नहीं कह सकते किसी बच्चे का कोई प्रॉब्लम है बोर्ड एग्जाम्स में, कोई कुछ उसके कोई कॉज हो गया गलती से, तो वो अपना इसमें इंप्रूव कर सकता है.
तो बोर्ड एग्जाम्स में भी तो इंप्रूव हो सकता है.
बट मैम, अगर किसी के साथ कुछ प्रॉब्लम हो तो वो वहाँ पे कोई फेस नहीं कर पाएगा.
ओके, आपका क्या कहना है? व्हाट अबाउट यू भानु प्रताप, अनदर क्लास 12 स्टूडेंट?
यस, आई एम इन फेवर ऑफ दिस न्यू सिस्टम. First of all, this board thing, it is more of memorizing definitions and all that. But this test comprises more of MCQs, so it tests on concepts. So when you go to your real work, your profession, you are good at applying. You are already good at applying. You are not good at just memorizing. You are applying the things and you have got a habit for it. So I think that works good for our minds.
Okay. Let me bring the academicians now, and I'll be joined by another student in just a bit from my home state of Bihar. Dr. Geeta Bhatt, one view is that, of course, as you heard from the students, that it is in their interest. But I would like to give a counter view. There are several universities where students aspire for, several top colleges of the country, their students aspire for that, and that is the reason they work with a bullheaded clarity, that if they get 98-99%, they would be able to make that cut for these top universities. Why should they suffer?
Well, Maria, I think any student who has a good understanding, conceptual understanding of the subject, and is able to come forward to apply the knowledge in terms of any subject, will be able to sit for any examination, including the board examination. Now, we have seen time and again, especially with reference to Delhi University, that there is so much of disparity the way in which the marking system is done in the various board examinations, that at times some students, they are not in an advantageous position vis-a-vis other boards where there is much more liberal marking. And this trend has been seen sometimes in colleges, that from one particular board, a large number of students are able to join one of the premier colleges. So this is an opportunity which is in consonance with what has come out in the policy document of the National Education Policy.
That's right.
Where it has been suggested that and proposed that there should be a common entrance exam for all the university degree colleges, so that the students, they get a level playing field.
And now, while we argue exam, that level playing field logic, Professor Chandrachur Singh, come in on this. You know, there is an ICSE board, and there are other local state boards as well, where the marks may not be as high as, say, the CBSC. Then, if we have not been able to fix that till now, because, you know, students coming from Bihar, say, from Bihar board and others, they have a disadvantage. If we have not been able to, for all these years, fix that anomaly, then how are we looking at this common entrance test?
Well, Maria, thank you for giving me the opportunity, and I'm sorry because I was traveling, so I'm just joining you from my car. But I think, to be honest, the proposal seems and sounds very intuitive. But Maria, I think this is the time, and it's time right now for us to call a spade a spade. Straight jacketing may create more problems than it may solve. Why am I saying this? I'm saying this basically because if you look to the university structure in India, the structures are not uniform. Forget about the academic standards. There are different types of universities. You have federal universities, you have unitary universities, you have quasi-federal universities, you have standalone institutions. So how would this system fit all of them together into a straight jacket is something that people would have to deliberate upon. It's not that simple. I mean, remember, in 2010, you had the CUCET, and I think the CUCET system is still on. But do let me know, I mean, and yes, you correct me if I'm wrong, there are only 14 central universities.
Okay.
Just give me a more minute.
Yes.
The fact of the matter is that perhaps such a solution, such a situation, and such a proposal can fit into universities which are of the similar kind, but of different standards, different in institutions. It is likely to be a bit more difficult than it sounds.
So are you of the opinion that there has to be grading of the universities first, and then such a proposal must be implemented? Dr. Geeta Bhatt, respond to this point. That straight jacketing of an idea may not be the best one. It cannot be one size fit all, because universities are in India have different criteria in terms of their can one aptitude test be applicable, say, to a Delhi University, a pretty prestigious university, and say a university in back of beyond of India where the professors and the college in the colleges aren't there.
Well, Mario, when we can have, we can have an entrance examination for a large number of professional colleges, medical colleges, which are spread across the country. Similarly, we have one unified entrance examination for all the engineering colleges, which are spread across the country. Then why is it that we cannot think in terms for graduate degrees for pure sciences, humanities, or visual arts, or vocational colleges across
so
the
how
country.
Will it work, Dr. Geeta Bhatt? Say a student qualifies. I'm just hypothetically just help me understand. Yeah, so how will it work? So if a student gets a particular percentage in this common entrance examination, on what basis will it be decided whether he will get admission in a Hindu college or whether he'll be going to say a college in Bihar or UP or some other state?
Well, you see, this is for what that already there is a 7-member committee has been constituted by the government to look into and decide on the modalities, and I'm sure it will work out exactly the same way it is done for medical colleges. For example, those colleges which are graded higher, or AIIMS, or there are similar other colleges which they have their own ranking in medical colleges, similarly in engineering colleges. In the same way, there can be a ranking for the colleges across the country, especially which are constituent colleges of central universities, because at present this has been proposed for the nearly 50 plus central universities, which are listed
but
in
not
UGC.
Every central
so
university has
them.
The same quality of education. That is where the issue is. I am not convinced with this basic premise that all central universities have the same set of good quality teachers and professors, even classrooms. So how will this really work on ground, Professor Singh?
Well, Maria, I think what the problem is that this, it's like, the problem is somewhere else. The solutions are being, given from above. I think, one needs to understand, even Delhi University, remember, forget about those technical courses where Ms. Bhatt is right in saying that, technical courses are similar in nature. But even Delhi University had this entrance test for English, for admission to undergraduate courses in Delhi. And please understand, they had to give up and the system had to be scrapped. What I'm trying to tell you is that the solution should come. This skyrocketing of cutoff is something which is nonsensical. But I think the solution should come right from creating structures in the universities. For example, you have all different kinds of boards. Let there be a system of equivalence. Let the colleges have some kind of additional padding where they can have their own criteria for looking into admissions. For example, sports. This is how the universities in the West do. I mean, it's just not marks. The 12th marks is just one thing.
Then in that case, should the 12th marks be done away with? If it has just come to about the common entrance test, then what is really the purpose of class 12th examination? Come in on this. The two students on the screen now, please. Bhanu Pratap and Sumit Raghav. Bhanu Pratap, it's all very well to say that this is a great move. As a student, will you be comfortable being in the same grading, say, if you manage to get a 90% with somebody who's a 60%er?
Can you repeat, please?
Mera sawal ye hai ki agar aapko 90% aata hai, aur aap, you can manage admission in, say, St. Stephen's or St. Xavier's. और किसी को 60% आता है लेकिन वो कॉमन एंट्रेंस टेस्ट में आपसे बेहतर परफॉर्म करते हैं, देन हाइपोथेटिकली आई एम आस्किंग यू.
हाँ, अच्छा, तो देख, अभी तो बोर्ड्स जिस हिसाब से बता रहे हैं कि एक ही एग्जाम होगा उसके बेसिस पे जज किया जाएगा, तो बोर्ड्स का करना है क्या है? मतलब बोर्ड्स के मार्क्स से क्या मतलब है जब सब कुछ उसी एग्जाम से होना है?
सो यू आर सेइंग द बोर्ड्स शुड बी डन अवे विद. So that's certainly not a bad idea, Dr. Geeta, but what is the purpose of board exams now? Dr. Geeta Bhatt, I think we'll try and connect with Dr. Geeta Bhatt in just a bit. Come in on this. Sumit Raga, what's your view?
Ma'am, if a student is not score good marks in board exam, so how is score good marks in at that entrance exam?
I'm not getting it. Yeah.
मैम, अगर कोई बच्चा बोर्ड एग्जाम्स में अच्छे नहीं नंबर ला सकता, तो उस एंट्रेंस एग्जाम में कैसे अच्छे नंबर ला सकता है?
No, but अगर, because you said that, you made that point, right, Raghav, that in case if the circumstances, say there was an ailing member in the family and hence that person could not really concentrate in the exams, so that person did not really manage a good number. Maybe a score did suffer because of multiple circumstances around that student. If that student suffers because of that and then manages to do phenomenally well in common entrance examination, is it fair then? How is it really a level playing field?
So, ma'am, this is fair. The student is जो मतलब इसने पढ़ाई की, अगर उस समय नहीं पढ़ पाया तो इस समय पढ़ पढ़ के वो अच्छे नंबर आ रहा है, तो वो मतलब कि उसने क्वालिटेटिव एजुकेशन तो ली है ना, तो पढ़ रहा है. तो मेन मोटिव तो यही है कि एग्जामिनेशन का, कि बच्चे पढ़ें और एग्जाम दें और हम अच्छे बच्चों को लें. तो अच्छा बच्चा तो है ना, पढ़ने में तो है.
सो आप चाहते हैं व्हेन यू टेक द एग्जाम्स देयर शुड बी अ कॉमन एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन सो दैट यू कैन फाइंड एन एंट्री इनटू अ टॉप यूनिवर्सिटी.
या मैम.
And what do you think should be the basis of, you know, deciding the universities? If you qualify, if it is just on the basis of qualifying in the common entrance examination, you qualify in a common entrance examination. But should it be left on you to decide which college?
Yes, ma'am.
It should be left on you.
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
Okay, so there are a lot of questions there. Dr. Geeta Bhatt. Dr. Bhatt, if you can hear me.
Yes, yes, now I am audible. Earlier, there was some audible.
Fine enough, go ahead. There are concerns being shared by students. Please answer.
Yeah, I couldn't hear what they were saying. Can you just repeat in brief what they mentioned?
Yes, I will ask Bhanu Pratap to repeat his question. Bhanu Pratap, what is the purpose of class 12th exams?
Yes, now don't see any. If you prepared good for boards only to get a good university, but now you are saying that there is going to be a different exam, so why boards? What will you do with that?
Why boards?
And why should people there?
Dr. Geeta Bhatt.
Well, you see, there is going to be, you know, in the national education policy, there will be in the coming years, there is going to be there will be three-tier universities, where there will be research-oriented university, educational universities, and there will be autonomous college bodies. So it's a phased-out, change that is going to take place over the coming years, and this is one of the first steps which is being formulated. So this is something maybe in later years, the kind of examinations that are going to be for class 10th and class 12th students will also have some kind of a change which may be possible. As there is going to be change in the way the colleges are going to be categorized, so hopefully there will be, there's some colleges where these board exam results will be of will have some value for getting admission into. So this is something that we can only see in the coming years as the national education policy gets implemented.
So as it takes shape, there are several uncertainties or undecided spaces, and that is the reason why these questions are coming from the students. Professor Singh, come in on this again. If a student with 60% will be, even a candidate with 60% will be able to sit for common entrance examination and perhaps qualify for admissions, then how is this fair to someone who has managed a 95% or maybe a 98%?
Marga, I mean, this is what I was trying to tell you. See, the point is, the whole system should be such where the stress of the students is lessened. Now, imagine a single test for so many courses. Will it going to steep, make the process tougher for students, or is it going to bring any ease to them? The question is that, the moment you have such kind of a system, the universities will have very a tough time. Imagine Delhi University telling you that the Hindu college is better than Shradhanand College or Miss Bhatt's college. I mean, is it something which can be accepted in theory anywhere? No. Similarly, it is valid in IITs. It's valid in the NEET system. But it is not valid here, because here we are also, remember, competing with the private universities. So the point is that, if you really want to help the students, I think the colleges need to be given some kind of autonomy to really test the students apart from whatever
Professor
he or
Singh,
she may have
that is exactly because the colleges so far have had that autonomy. There are several colleges which do not have entrance examination. They purely take students in undergrad, graduation for on the basis of their marks. Now the question is that this will give the level playing field is what the argument of the government is.
Let me clarify, Maria. As of now, the colleges do not have any autonomy. Anybody who makes to the cutoff has to be selected. Let me give you an example. This year, Hindu College Political Science had 99.5% as cutoff. And against 18 seats, please understand this, we have 18 sanctioned general seats. Remember, we had to take 108 admissions, 40 of them have 100%. Now, where is the autonomy? What did we do? We did nothing because anybody who made it had to be admitted. That is why I'm saying trust your colleagues, trust the academics in this country, give them some rope, give them some idea, give them the time to devise mechanisms through which they can not only test the proficiency of the students, but they can also see which student is going to which direction. So as of now, having a straight jacket one proficiency test is not going to cater to liberal
30
humanities.
Seconds to you,
it's not going to cater
Dr. Geeta Bhatt, and then I'll give the final words to the students.
Yeah, Maria, first of all, you see, there is already, if you talk in terms of ranking, there is already a ranking which of the various colleges across the country, which is done not only by some, very well-known organizations and publishers. Also, there is an NIRF ranking for which various colleges, whether it is Hindu College, whether it is JMC, or whether it is any other college, all the colleges are there applying for the, number one rank, and then it gets published. And even in their, on the website, everywhere, the colleges, they publicize what is their ranking in NIRF, and as well as their NAC ranking. So there is already an existing ranking structure. Now, for the also it is important to understand that the way the proficiency of a student is to be evaluated by a teacher is something that happens in the classroom. And this is something where we are talking in terms of the admission to a particular institute or to a particular college. Now, definitely, exactly in the same day, you see, there is always, whenever there is some change which takes place, then there is a resistance to that change because we are used to of a particular way or a system of working.
Fine. Let me give the final words to the two students, Sumit and Bhanu Pratap. Your final words, is this the move for you in the interest of the students like you? Sumit.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Bhanu Pratap, what do you think?
I think the professor which you have involved, he knows much better than us, and the flaws which he is pointing are very serious. So there needs to be working in the system, though it is doing good, I think.
All right. Thank you. Fine. Thank you so much for joining us. And we are going straight to a breaking news that is coming in from Andhra Pradesh. And this is about the United Kingdom returnees in the state. In all, the state is saying that there are 1,214 who returned from the UK, 1,158 have been traced, 56 are yet to be traced, and 6 are those who have tested positive in this. So certainly, this is about the scanning that is happening of the new strain of the coronavirus, if it has entered India already. Swastika is joining me on the phone line. Swastika, give us the details.
Well, the 6 positive cases that have come to light are of those who have returned from UK. But one thing is that it has not been ascertained yet whether the strain of COVID that has affected them is the new strain, as in the mutated strain, or the old strain. Now, the nodal agency which is looking after this is CCMB, where the samples of these patients have been sent, and it is going to take about 24 hours for the genome sequencing process, following which it can be ascertained determined whether the positive cases are of the mutated cases. In either ways, the precautionary measure that has been taken by the state government is that separate isolation wards have been created for those patients who have tested positive and have returned from UK. Same protocol is also being followed in Telangana, where the patients who have tested positive from UK are under observation, and their samples too have been sent to NIV Pune as well as CCMB. Back to you.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us, Swastika Das there. We're slipping into a short break. On the other side, I will be joining you at 9 p.m. with the debate on love jihad, whether it's anti-love or not.